What's up, Divas? And what's up, Divos? It's your girl, April. And you guys already know what time it is. It is Real Talk Wednesday. And Real Talk for today, I am not about to put no makeup on for no video, okay? So let's just get into this Real Talk, y'all. So the first things first, we're going to get into this video, but before we even do, I want to just say thank you to everybody who has been watching my channel and just staying tuned with me every single week, at every single video, etc., etc. And I say this because a lot of times we don't come in here enough and thank everyone, but I just need you guys to know how much I appreciate every single one of you guys, regardless if you thumbs it down or thumbs it up. Or don't leave a comment or leave a comment. I just wanted to say thank you because you took time out of your day to watch me. So that means a lot to me. And like I said, sometimes we don't say thank you enough. And I just thought I would say thank you today. Today is a good day for me somehow, somewhat. I guess it's because I did wake up. I'm not going to put on any makeup today. I get tired of putting on makeup sometimes, especially if it's so hot outside. So I hope you guys don't mind me coming on here with my all natural. Well, not all natural, because you guys know this is a wig and this ain't my hair. But I didn't really hook it up too much. But in case you're wondering, this is the same wig that I have been wearing, gosh, for over a week now. It's the Vanessa brand Robust wig. I absolutely love this wig. And like I told you guys, it's like the twin sister to the Outre Nisha. Now, the one thing that's driving me crazy about her, and it happens with every single synthetic wig, and you know what? It is what it is. There's no way to get around it, is the ends start ratting up, okay? And I'm still like,
where's my brush? I need this wig to act right. You know what? I gotta get another one.
Riding to the beauty supply store asking, do you guys sell the Vanessa brand? And they're like, no. How you going to not sell the Vanessa brand? I'm looking for one particular wig. Though I know I could just reach out to one of the wig companies and
just be like, can you please send me another Robust wig in the color number 2. And if you want to send me something else, like the color number 1B or some other color that you got in the Robust, I'll take that as well.
Oh my god, so this is how much I love this wig. Like, it is so much life. Everybody is always like, your hair looks so nice, it looks so nice. I just be like, oh yes. But then when it starts ratting up at the ends, I just be like, But there is a way to work around that, and I will get to that sooner or later. But I want to tell you guys this. For those who have been asking me about this wig, yes, she is the sister wig to Nisha, but she is not the Mufasa sister, okay? So, you know, there's two sisters sometimes. There's one sister, there's the good sister, and there's the bad sister. Sometimes they're just not both the good sister. Well, Nisha is the bad sister because as soon as you put her on and you step outside that door, within matters of minutes, she is Mufasa. Whole attitude change. It's like The Exorcist when her head spins around. Total different attitude change. So she's kind of like the black sheep of the family, the bad sister. Then we have Vanessa, Robust, who is more settled and subtle and just calm, okay? So she's the good one. She is the good sister, you know? Good sister, bad sister. That's how those 2 weeks work out. Other than that, they're exact same. And I love this one so much. So I did put it on for the video because I wanted to look halfway decent. Along with that, I do have one of my favorite t-shirts on, and my kids will tell you in a heartbeat.
I wish she would throw that shirt in the garbage. It's like 10 years old and she's still wearing it. You keep wearing that shirt, somebody is definitely going to give you some charity.
Okay, so the shirt is really not that bad. I love this shirt. And yeah, it is like 10 or 11 years old. It is. I bought it from Target. This was before Mumsy was born. Mumsy's about to be 9. Okay, so yeah, it's like 10 years old. I love it. It's never ripped. It's never torn. It's a comfortable shirt. And I just think it goes well with everything. And I love this shirt. And I'm not going to throw it in the garbage. Okay? So, and if somebody wants to give me some type of charity for wearing this shirt, then by all means, let me carry a cup around with me. Okay, so there's no drink today, just some water because it is so hot outside and I am very dehydrated. Also, I am so excited to announce that tomorrow, you guys better check it out. This is my video collaboration with gslovesme.com. I am so excited about this video, like overly excited. You know how guys get really excited? You guys get really excited when you see the Fashion Nova videos. You know, you see all these girls in the Fashion Nova videos and they're like, oh, look at that. That's how I feel about gslovesme.com. GSLovesMe.com is like the bombest website, okay, on the web. And if you guys do not know who I'm talking about, then just Google them, Twitter them, Instagram them, okay, YouTube them. There are lots of videos, but they cater to plus size women like myself. Yes, I am plus size. For those who keep saying, I don't know how you could call yourself plus size on my latest fashion video, or leave an Instagram post about I'm not plus size, I'm glad that you bitches think that I'm not plus size and that you wear my clothes. But I failed to tell you guys, and I'm going to tell you again. I didn't fail because I did tell you. I wear a size 16, okay? 14/16. More on the 16 side, okay? I wear a size 1X. Depending on who makes the clothes, I wear a 1X and I never can fit in a large. Unfortunately, large is not my best friend. I do wear a 1X and I wear a size 16. So some people carry their weight totally different. I am short. I am 5'3", and the majority of my weight is in my midsection, okay? That is where most of it is at. So, but I am a 16. I got these big old legs. I am a 16. So I really wish that people would stop saying, I don't know how you could call yourself 16 or plus size or what have you. I don't know how you could write what you write, okay? You don't even know me that well. Come in my closet and then you'll see. I wear a size 16. I am plus size. And I wear a size 11 shoe, for those of you who didn't know that. So I am 5'3", I wear a size 11 shoe, and I wear a size 16 clothing. I used to wear a size 18-20 clothing until I lost a lot of weight. So I lost a lot of weight and then went down to size 10-12. Then I gained some weight back and went back to 14-16. And you know something? Either way, either here nor there, like I was saying about GS Loves Me, I absolutely love this website because you know how you go to websites and you see some plus size clothing, but there's only like 3 pages full of stuff, and then you see all the clothing for the non-plus size women. They have loads and loads of stuff. Well, they're not with GS Loves Me. They have probably like 70 pages worth of freaking clothing for plus size. And they upload stuff every single day. Yes, ladies. Every single day you go to that website and you click on the What's New section and you click on the category, you will see like 3 to 4 pages of brand new stuff. Brand new. Okay? Brand new stuff. So I love that about them. Plus, their prices are so affordable. And also, they are on that Fashion Nova kind of style spectrum as well. So when you girls are all into Fashion Nova, or you're tired of Fashion Nova, check out gslovesme.com. I'm not knocking Fashion Nova. I do like them as well. But they don't have as many items to choose from like GS Loves Me. Plus, their prices might be a little bit more higher. And like I said, GS Loves Me, they are on that same style spectrum, that same trending style as a lot of these websites are. So yes, I love them. I freaking am in love with GS Loves Me. I'm so happy. So yes, you guys, make sure you watch the video tomorrow, Thursday, for the YouTube video collaboration with GS Loves Me. It's nothing special. I'm in my house, in my downstairs dining room. It's a blank wall. But I'm just so excited because I really, really do like this website. And before the YouTube video collaboration even came about, I was buying stuff from them. Like buying stuff from them. I had to keep myself away from the website because every day, every single day, I would see myself like,
Let me just put this in my cart. I'm going to come back tomorrow and see if they got some new stuff because I might not want this.
So this is what I was doing, and then I would end up buying it, and then the next day I would buy something else. So it's like very addicting, very, very addicting. So yes, and also there is a 20% off coupon code. So all you got to do is use Muffin20 at time of checkout, and you will receive 20% off your purchase order. Also, free shipping for every United States order of $40 or more. So if you purchase something and you live in the United States and you purchase something $40 or more, you are going to get free standard shipping. And baby, their shipping is pretty fast to be standard. There ain't nothing standard about their shipping. So yes, you guys, let's get into this video. And oh, and also for those trolls that are watching, you know, you are, there are some trolls, you know. I say trolls because I did go back on to, one of my friends went on to Makeup Alley for me and found all this extra shit. Y'all trolls is something else. And I'm going to say trolls because y'all watching my video. And then y'all go report back to Makeup Alley like y'all some motherfucking spies and shit. Be like, oh my God. You know? Y'all spying and shit on me. Writing dumb shit. Like, y'all don't have nothing better to do. Y'all write, I'm going to keep saying it. Writing dumb shit. So I was in the witness protection. I was in the witness protection apartment. First of all, I haven't lived in an apartment in like 15, 20 years. And second of all, before I came here, I was in a witness protection apartment. That's what I heard, right? Why the fuck would I be in a witness protection program or any of the sort, okay? I lived in my own fucking house in New York, and then I moved here in Arizona, lived in my own fucking house. I'm not part of the mob. There's no reason for me to be in any type of witness protection program. It's crazy how these bitches just write up some dumb shit, but they'll sit there and watch the video. So for y'all trolls that's watching and reporting back to Lipstick Alley, thank you, and this is for you guys. Deuces and mwah, smooches to you. And continue to watch. I hope y'all girls learn something new while watching me and then reporting back to Makeup Alley, because that's what I expect y'all to do. And while you at it, write an article and send me an invitation to any kind of open event. I would love to show up and smile up in your face and be fake and phony, just like you do here on the YT. Yes. So on that note, let's get into this real talk, y'all. Okay, guys, so let's get into this real talk. I have four of them, and I'm going to do my best, yes, my best, to get all four of them done. And if I did not mention it, let me mention it to you now, that if you need a real talk about yourself or your life or what have you, then let me know. Send me an email to muffinismylovers2012@gmail.com. And put in the subject line real talk. And if you want to change the name of your characters in this email, then please go ahead and do so. All right. Hi, April. First, I want to say I love, love, love your videos and your attitude. I've been watching since way back when you drove over that wig with your car. I'll explain that to you guys in a minute. So let's say for the purposes of this, my name is Monica. I'm 25 years old with a good job and I live in Ireland. The one thing that I'm hung up on is that I've been single for over 2 years or so now. It almost feels like no one is attracted to me. Tried the online thing like you said in your recent videos, Diva, nothing but weirdos. I live in Ireland, and I think men here just do not appreciate a curvy figure. Laugh out loud, it's a fact. And trust me, I want to tone up a bit, but for me, I'm definitely not skinny type of material. So my question is, how do I put myself out there? Not going to lie, partying is so old and not into that. Online thing seems like a waste of time. I find in times when I'm lonely, I always think about my ex. We were together for about 4 years and I found out in the last two, the whole time he was seeing another woman. I left him so fast and was so hurt, but at times I feel like he's the only one I've ever had and I will never find anyone. I've had a few on and offs since, but girl, nothing but losers. Now I'm being picky, but I feel like any guy I have remotely liked is either not interested or only wants a one-night stand. I feel like I'm stuck in a rut and just feel very unattractive. Am I being too harsh on myself? Thank you, Diva. Okay, well, Monica. So for the car thing, I did run over a half wig called Tropical Spice by Model Models, like when I first started on YouTube back in 2009, I think it was. The wig swelled up so bad by the end of the day, like the middle of the day, that I came home and just threw it on the ground and ran over it and video recorded myself running over the damn wig. It was like the worst experience. There were people looking at me in the street with this hair on, like crazy weird looks, and I know it was the hair. So, oh man, I really wish that channel would never have gotten hacked, because you guys could have seen that video. It was hilarious to a lot of people, but to me, it was just like, wow. Cannot believe that this happened to me. I walked outside and I came back in looking like a big ass Mufasa cotton ball. So yes, that was me back then. So Monica basically is She's young. She's 25 years old. She hasn't been in a relationship for the past 2 years, and she feels like nobody wants her. She lives in Ireland. She had dated someone for 4 years and found out that the last 2 years of the relationship was fake and phony because her ex was cheating on her with somebody. And she's tried the online dating thing. She feels like the men out there in Ireland do not like the curvy girls. And she just feels like she's just stuck in a rut. And no one finds her attractive. And the men that she is dating or has dated, they just want one thing. Honestly, Monica, and you are being a little bit too harsh on yourself when you ask me that question. And I'm going to be the first one to tell you that, because I be feeling the same way sometimes. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I get what you're saying. Like, you sit around because you're lonely, you're bored, and you think about your ex. Don't get me wrong, you guys. I feel the same way, too, because I'm only human. You know what I'm saying? I'm only human. So, yeah, I do sit around sometimes, and I do think about my ex, too, the one that I was with for so long. And it feels like, will anybody ever love me as much? But then you have to realize that those people really didn't love you. You just were with them for a certain amount of time, and that's what you know, or that's what you remember the most of. You know what I'm saying? And here it is. It's a new day and age, and you're still trying to find someone that will kind of like replace them or just give you that satisfaction. You can never say you're being too picky when it becomes a relationship, because there are so many weirdos out there in this world. Like, seriously, there are some weirdos, okay? Trust and believe. You know, I already said my piece about Blue Eyes from last week's episode, and you know, he kept constantly talking about, oh, when I move in with you, like, hold the fuck up. You know what I'm saying? I think he has some type of black woman fetish. I really do. But then when I wasn't giving him the time of day like that no more, I guess that just went out the door, okay? So, it is what it is. But, I think you are being a little bit hard on yourself. I have been single myself for quite a while, too. Not, after I left New York and I came here. I left New York in 2013 at the end of June. Took me some days to drive here. Like, in the middle of June, because I stopped off in Pennsylvania and stayed with my dad 2 weeks. So, when I got here, it was July 10th, 2013. So, and I was single all that time. You know, I wasn't in a relationship with anybody until October that just passed, 2015, when my ex-boyfriend, you know, the one who always bragging about the computer, that he bought me and shit, you know what I'm saying? Because he was in New York. So, and that was just like talking on the phone, so I really couldn't count that. But anyway, so and sometimes I was single for longer than that too sometimes. But I think that we are a little bit harsh on ourselves at times as women, or just even as people. You know, I say the same thing though, to be honest. Like, I always pick myself apart, and that's probably not a good thing. And at least I could tell you guys that, because I've never told anybody that before, but I do it. I pick myself apart at the end of the day, not every day, but at the end of the day, you know, I take off my makeup and then I take off my hair and I look at myself in the mirror sometimes. And I just look at myself and I just get really kind of like, I can't say disgusted, but I just kind of be like, who is going to want to be with you? Look at you. You have no hair. Well, I have hair, but you know, you look a million times better with your makeup on and your hair on. And this is just how I be feeling sometimes. You're out of shape. You have a stomach. You have to wear a body garment. And you know, sometimes I feel like, you ever seen that movie, I'ma Get You Sucker, and a girl, the light-skinned girl, she's at the bar, she goes home with the guy, she takes off her wig, she takes off her leg, she takes off her butt, and she's just a totally different person? That's how I be feeling sometimes about myself, because I take off my makeup, I take off my wig, I take off my body garment, which is kind of like taking off your leg, and then, you know, and then I'm more comfortable. So that's sometimes how I feel, and the guy just runs off, and that's how I feel about myself. But, you know, we are a little bit too harsh on ourselves. So, and I can be the first to say, I pick myself apart a lot. And there was a time that I would never go outside without makeup or without my hair being done. And I just wouldn't. And I have come to the realization that I'm a human being. Regardless, at the end of the day, I'm a human being. And I have no problem now going outside shopping or going wherever the fuck I'm going with my headscarf wrapped really pretty and no makeup on. And I have no issue with it. And like today, I got on here with no makeup on. I thought about it and I said, you know what, should I do my makeup for this video? And I'm like, hell no, I ain't doing my damn makeup. I'm gonna go on there just like this. This is me, this is who I am. And if don't nobody want to watch the shit, then they could just not fucking watch it. I don't care, but I'm a human being. I don't wake up flawless. I don't fucking wake up with my face beat. You know what I'm saying? Honestly, to be truthful, it's too damn hot out here to have your face beat. I be sweating and I could really care less about my face being beat in 114 degree weather. That's just not for me. So, yeah. But I think that you are kind of hard on yourself. You know what I'm saying? 2 years is not a long time. And it's not that you want to put yourself out there, because if you put yourself out there, you are going to attract sometimes the wrong type of people. And we don't really want to attract those type of people, though we have already. But I wouldn't say put myself out there. Sometimes shit happens that you least expect it. When you least freaking expect it, you never know what's going to come about. Walking down the street one day, and a perfect gentleman come into your presence and start a conversation with you. You just don't know. So sometimes it's like this. When you go seeking and looking for love, you know that song, looking for love in all the wrong places, looking for love. That's what it really is. You're looking for love, but you're really looking in the wrong places, because if you have to search for love and look for it, you ain't going to find it. You know what I mean? You're not going to find true love when you're looking for it. You know what I mean? You cannot look for shit and think that you're going to find the right thing. That's the reason the song is made up, looking for love in all the wrong places. Yeah, it's wrong places, right? Yeah, it is wrong places. But when you got to go searching for love and shit, it's just like, okay, I am not going to find the right thing, because you're wanting something so bad and you're wanting to be loved that you kind of push your certain morals and values aside because you just want to be loved. And it's never called being picky. Sometimes I think that way about my own stuff, like, oh, I'm being too picky about someone that I would date. But you know what? We have all been through some shit in our life that we have the right to be picky. I'm sorry, but I think I have the right to be picky, especially because I have been through enough, and I don't really want to be with a weirdo, because a weirdo is a weirdo. You never know what they're capable of doing. So I think, like, just to be on the safe side, it's always best to be picky. And yeah, the dating website, the online dating thing, you know, it's cool for a minute, but then it starts to get, like, really tiresome. It kind of gets boring and you start seeing things in a different light. It's just like, okay, these niggas out here is just all fucking stupid. Either they all on here for one thing, regardless if you pay for the website or not, they're all on here for one thing and one thing only. So I really can't fuck with the online dating thing anymore. I just can't. I'm just like, you know, maybe I'll try it again sometime in the late future. But right now, I think I'm just cool. The last situation with Blue Eyes, that kind of like blew my mind. Like, I was just like weirded out, like totally weirded out by the whole thing, like with the dirty car thing. He's saying you could tell by someone's car if they're a clean person when his freaking microwave looked like all kind of bugs and shit were living in. It was like disgusting. I've never seen anybody's microwave like that in my life. Thank God I wasn't hungry. Thank God I ate already. And if that's where you want your food to go, then hey, that's where you want your food to go. And I'm glad that I brought him over some food, because I got to see his real true self behind closed doors, because it was a closed door. You know what I mean? The microwave, it just was really gross. And just the thing about him just constantly, it seemed like it was just too much. You, even if you say it one time to me when I move in with you, like, hold the fuck up. Damn, it's only been a week and a half. Why is you even saying that? You scaring me. You scaring a bitch, nigga. You scaring a bitch. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, he kind of like really weirded me out with that. Totally weirded me out. And just like the red flag, you know, talking about your son's mother downgrading her to me, was just like, you know what? Okay, I've already dealt with that. Let's halt. So I think he kind of got the picture when I stopped texting back, and kind of like my texts was kind of like very blank. You know what I mean? I had to ask my girl Shay, what do I do? I don't even like dude no more. Like, what do I do? She was just like, don't be texting back anymore. And she said it works. She was right. It did work. He fucking stopped texting me. Guess I wasn't good enough. My car wasn't clean. But yeah, I think you are being a little bit hard on yourself. Just give it a chance. Give it a moment. Take a break. Stop worrying about a love life. You're young. You're 25 years old. Girl, please, I'm 42, so shit. You're 25 years old. You got your whole life ahead of you. Mr. Right is going to come along. They always do, especially when you're not looking. And I know it bothers you sometimes. You see all these fucking women out there, and they're lovely relationships, and they're in la-la land. They're just as happy. But you know what? Your time will come. Your time will come. Mr. Right will come for you. You just need to relax and just give it a moment's rest, and I'm pretty sure that you will find the right one. So, yes, that is my take on that. Okay, so this is more or less like a friendship type of one. I like these ones. Hey, Miss April, I just wanted to say I'm a huge supporter of yours, especially your Real Talk videos. So much that me and my husband set aside time every Wednesday to make sure we watch it with a snack and a drink. Anywho, I need your advice. For the video purposes, you can call me Chanel. I have a best friend, Leslie, that I need some advice about. Me and Leslie have been friends since we were about 4 years old. We lost contact throughout our high school years, but ended up reconnecting years later and has been close ever since. Leslie is the type of girl who rubs people the wrong way. A lot of people in our neighborhood used to call her fake and phony. However, for some stupid reason, I would try to see the good in her and make excuses for how she acted because of her childhood. Fast forward to recently. In October of last year, Leslie got married to this guy named Robert. Her and Robert had been together for 9 years before they got married. And to be honest, the only reason why they got married was because she gave him an ultimatum and said either he marries her or her and the kids they have together will leave. Now, to be honest, April, their relationship has been a hot damn mess over the years. Between the fighting, both parties cheating on each other, side chicks, side dudes, girl, a mess. And I was always the friend that she can go to when she wanted to vent, and I would be there. Girl, and yes, they still got married to each other. Shaking my head, LOL. Fast forward again to December. Me and my now husband got engaged on Christmas Eve. We've only was together for a year. However, it was a whirlwind romance, and we've been happy ever since. However, when I told everyone I was engaged, it seems like things changed for me and Leslie at that point. In January, my aunt threw a surprise bridal shower. At the party, Leslie acted real stank. And every time someone would gush about me and my husband's upcoming wedding, she would get an attitude and try to make it about her. Then comes my wedding day. I had a non-traditional wedding in March. However, it was beautiful. Tell me why Leslie showed up an hour late. While taking pictures, my husband noticed that she just kept making faces and acted like she didn't want to be there. She had a stank attitude the whole time. In fact, her attitude was so bad that people that attended my wedding started to notice. Everyone said the same thing. She acted like she didn't want to be there. Every time someone would dote on me, she would butt in and try to make the situation about her. She then started trying to compare her wedding to mine at the damn wedding. It's like every time I do something, she always feels the need to compete. And I'm tired of it. In March, me and my husband got a house. While in the process of getting the house, she tells me that I shouldn't own a home because it's a lot of work and it'll be better to rent. In my head, I'm thinking, bitch, since when? Of course, I didn't take her advice, and guess what? 3 weeks later, this bitch gets her own house. Then my husband gets a new job for the city. She wants to know how much he makes, when does he go to work. I'm like, this bitch lost her damn mind. Who does that? She constantly competes with me and then tries to downplay what I have. I recently went to visit her and seen we had some of the same appliances, which is not a big deal to me. When I told her, oh, I have the same thing, she made a point to say, oh, no, mine's a state of the art. I'm like, bitch, it's not that serious. My last straw was with her 2 months ago. My car caught on fire while I was driving. The fire was really bad, but luckily I was able to get out before I was hurt. I called her to tell her because I was scared. You know, the first thing she said was, dang, what you gonna do now, girl? You just got that car. The way she said it was in aha type of way. Instead of asking me if I was okay, I just felt some type of way. I decided that I just don't want to fuck with her anymore. I can't be friends with anybody who thinks everything is a competition. Now, here's the thing, April. I'm the type of person, when I don't fuck with you, I just stop fucking with you. I don't give no warning, no explanation. I just cut a bitch off and keep it moving. However, my husband agrees that I should stop being friends with her, but have a conversation with her on why I don't want to be her friend. I don't agree. I feel like we're grown. Why do I need to tell her another woman I don't agree. I feel like we're grown. Why do I need to tell another woman what they did? Another grown-ass motherfucker what they did? My question to you is, what do you think? Am I wrong for just cutting this bitch off with no explanation? Sorry for the long letter, girl. Love you. Okay. So Chanel and Leslie been friends since they were 4 years old, and Leslie is more or less one that rubs people the wrong way. And she is basically kind of like always in competition with Chanel. Chanel gets something, she want to get it. Chanel gets something, Leslie want to downplay it and then go out and catch it and get it again. Just constantly downplaying. They ain't got nothing good to say. Nobody don't barely like her. She tired of it. She got tired of it. After a while, that shit do get kind of tiring. I can totally agree. You know what I'm saying? Life is short. And friends come a dime a dozen. That's why I always say to y'all, my friendship circle is like a dot. You know what I'm saying? I have my one friend that lives here, and then I have my one friend that lives in Texas. And let me see. If I gotta sit here, and I have my other friend that lives in Cali. Okay, so I got Chrissy, I got Shay, I got my friend Nicole. Okay, well, then, if I had to think about how many friends I got, then I ain't really got too many friends. Right? Do I have any other friends out here? Nope. No, I don't. So, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, my friendship circle is a dot. And these people that I have been friends with have been friends with me for ages, except for Nicole. But we've been friends since I moved out here for 3 years. So, and she's the person that she acts just like me. And then my girl Shay, she acts just like me. We act the same. We are the same kind of person. You know what I'm saying? We are both Geminis. We have the same attitude. So we can be around each other. We can be around each other and it don't be like no competition thing. Plus, our values are the same. We don't be on that petty shit. We don't be on that materialistic bullshit. You know what I'm saying? Me and her. So we can relate to each other. And I think when me and Shay, we can relate to each other a whole lot more than I've had a friendship with anybody else. And I have been friends with Shay since we have started on YouTube, since 2009. So that's a long time, you know what I'm saying? And, like, I've had other friends that have come and gone, and I'm the same way, Chanel. If I don't want to fuck with you no more, I don't fuck with you. I don't feel like I need to fuck with you. I don't feel like I need to give you any kind of explanation of why I'm not fucking with you no more. If you be on some petty bullshit and do little snide shit and post up little dumb ass shit on social media or say little shit and you think that I don't know about it or we don't know about it, what have you, I'm not going to feed into that. I just stop fucking with you because I know that you fake and phony and I'm not going to fuck with you. And on top of that, there are just like a lot of little things that I have seen in my life as growing up as an adult to where, you know what, a lot of bitches I just don't fuck with, I'm not going to fuck with, okay? I'm just not going to deal with a lot of shit. I'm 42 years old and I don't feel like I need to explain to any grown ass woman myself why I'm not fucking with you. If I'm not fucking with you, obviously there's a reason for it. And you know it. I don't really feel like I have to bring it to your attention, okay? And if you don't know the reason, then you know what, you're just as dumb as they fucking come. However, I don't feel like I need to explain to you why I'm not fucking with you no more. But then, you know what? Some people need clarification. And with your friend, Leslie, I don't know, like, I'm kind of in between, yes and no. Like, tell the bitch off. Like, you know what I'm saying? Because sometimes you just got to tell a person how it is. You got to tell a person what you feel about them and what the fuck they did to you. And the only reason why I say this is because you're not going to be able to get over certain shit that they have done to you until you basically confront them. You know what I mean? Until you confront them, you're not going to be able to get over what they have done to you or the little snide things that they have done to you that piss you the fuck off, you know? Oh, is it getting dark out? The sun is gone. So sometimes you do need to basically tell the person, this is why I'm not fucking with you no more. Let me turn my light. So you need to tell them, this is why I'm not fucking with you no more. Now you see why I stopped fucking with you. This is the things that you have done to me. And if you don't tell the person, it kind of like eats at you and eats at you. And I have like a situation like that myself where, you know, I could say something, but the type of person I am, I know if I tell you the reason why I'm not fucking with you anymore, et cetera, et cetera. I'm going to come out and say it the wrong way, and you're going to take it the wrong way, and then you're going to say something back in return, and then I'm going to get real fucking pissed off with you, and then I'm going to spaz the fuck out on you, and then it's going to be some bullshit. So I don't say anything. And sometimes I feel like this about myself. If I say something to you about the things that you have done that have pissed me off and have made me feel a certain type of way, then you're going to apologize to it. And the type of person I am a very forgiving person. Sometimes too forgiving. There is a good thing in being forgiving, but sometimes you can be so forgiving that it's not a good quality. You know what I'm saying? That means that you let people walk all over you when you are too forgiving. So sometimes I just feel like this about myself. I'm not going to fuck with you no more. I'm not telling you why I'm not fucking with you no more. You know why the fuck I'm not fucking with you no more. If I tell you, then you're going to apologize, and then we're gonna be like, girl, I miss you. Oh my god. I don't want to deal with that because I don't want the friendship anymore. So the best thing for me to do is just to walk away from it. And you cannot force yourself to be you just can't force yourself to sit there and have to tell somebody how they made you feel. If they made you feel a certain type of way and you've constantly told this to them, like, this is what you've done to me. This is what you've done to me. This is what you've done to me. You made me feel this way. You made me feel this way. You made me feel this way. And if I have to tell you over and over again, girl, please, you're not even paying attention. You obviously don't give a fuck, so why the fuck should I? I don't think I owe you any explanation. Now, if the bitch keep calling you and she's texting you and she's asking you why you ain't return her calls and stuff, you know what? I know this might sound petty to some, but I would just tell her, listen, Leslie, I'm not fucking with you no more. I don't like your attitude. I don't like the way you go about stuff, and I don't like the way you make me and other people feel around you. So I decided to keep my distance from you. If she keep continuously ask you why you don't fuck with her, then I would hit her with that. Other than that, I would not approach her. I wouldn't, like, open the doors to open the fucking doors and the gates to hell saying, bitch, the reason why I don't fuck with you is because. Okay. Don't open the doors. Just leave it the fuck alone. And your husband, he might have his point and reason why, because he's probably one of those who want to know why someone is not talking to him and speaking to him again. And I get it. Me, I'm the type of person, if you ain't speaking to me again, I don't give a fuck. You know what I'm saying? And that's just the type of person I am. Because at the end of the day, you ain't doing shit for me. I'm still living and breathing and have to provide everything over my head, this roof, these clothes, these food, and everything. So if you ain't speaking to me no more, I don't really give a fuck. Okay, you ain't speaking to me. Okay, boo. I'm not going to cry about it. Okay, I'm good if you don't want to speak to me. Life goes on. But as long as you feel comfortable in what you did and your decision, then feel comfortable with it. If she keep asking you why you ain't speaking to her, then by all means, let her know why you ain't talking to her. But like I said, don't go opening up doors. Leave it alone. Some things are left better alone, okay? Sometimes you just have to leave things alone and not bother with them. Just leave things well enough alone. And that is just the bottom line. Leave things well enough alone. And that's just my opinion. So let her know what you guys think about it. If you had a situation with a friend like that, what would you do? Would you just leave it alone? Would you, you know, what would you do? Now here goes one, which this one is so interesting. When I read it, I was like, oh my God, girl, what is you doing? You should know better. Okay. Hello, April. Thank you for doing these real talks, giving us that much needed real advice. Here's my situation. I recently ended an 8-year relationship with my children's father. I was always curious about women, so with this newfound freedom, I decided to go on a dating app and find a female companion. There was one in particular that caught my eye. She said she was 24. Come to find out, she's 23. I'm 26 and don't really deal with people my age, but I decided to step outside of the box and give her a shot. Right away, she informed me that she's best friends with her ex-girlfriend. She explained that they aren't attracted to one another. Mm-hmm, okay. She told me that she works part-time at a school. Her friend works there as well. Doesn't save money. She still lives at home with her guardian. Doesn't drive. Me, I own 2 businesses, plus I'm in school. I own a 2017 Jeep. I'm not used to being with someone like this. She spends recklessly on name brand shit, but cries broke when that check runs out. She only has 1 bill to pay, a $30 Boost Mobile phone that seems to be off once a month. This is slowly turning me off, but here's the kicker. A week ago, she goes on Facebook and posts a pic of her and her best friend, captioned, Mr. and Mrs. April, I went off. I cursed her the fuck out. Nigga, you can't even compare to my ex, but you're on Facebook showing this chick off like a trophy. She apologized for it, but still has been posting pics about her best friend, talking about how amazing she is. They spend each day and every day together. After work, she's right over at her house till 12 a.m. I only see her once a week, if that. So not only are you broke, you spend foolishly and live with a guardian, but you have the nerve to rub this bitch in my face. April, I want to leave this chick where she stands. What would you do? Well, first of all, she didn't give me no name to call her, so we're going to call her Olivia. Olivia, what the fuck you think you should do? First of all, you just said everything that she does that you don't fucking like. She don't have no fucking apartment of her own. No, she don't have a car. She best friends with her ex, and they ain't attracted to her, but she's over her house every single day posting up pictures on Facebook and whatever kind of social media there is, talking about Mr. and Mrs., talking about how amazing her ex is, which is really her best friend now. Girl, please, that bitch is just like a nigga, all right? That's how she acting, just like a nigga. I'm sorry. But she acting like a man. And she don't really have anything to bring to the table to you. Now, I'm not saying get with somebody because they got something to offer. But goddamn, don't get with a fucking leech and a bum and one that's cheating on you and treating you like shit. I'm not saying she cheating, but I'm just saying, if she over this girl house every day till 12 a.m. and you only see her once a week, but she's giving all her time to her ex, which is now her best friend, and posting up pictures of Mr. and Mrs. What's that go to say? That means that she's fucking with this bitch. Obviously, she's pulling the wool over your eyes. What are you, like her sugar mama? Okay, and then she lives at home with her guardian. Did Olivia call her her guardian? She didn't even say she lived at home with her mother or her parents. She said guardian, all right? So she lives at home with her guardian, never got no money, is always broke. I'm sorry, but it's nice to be having our own shit. Like, you got your own apartment and I got my own apartment. And sometimes I can go over to your apartment, we can relax. And sometimes you come over to mine. But no, bitch, you got to always come over to my shit because you live at home with your guardian. And I always got to come pick your ass up because you ain't got no car. Or you probably ain't got no bus or cab or Uber money. So I always got to pick you up, all right? And then if we want to go out somewhere, I got to foot the bill because your broke ass is always fucking broke. Okay? Now, I'm sorry, but I'm just really not going to put up with that. It's cool that you want to find love out there and you want to find a relationship with a woman now because men probably done pissed you the fuck off so much and you got tired of it. But let me tell you something. Women are the same. Just because they ain't got no dick does not mean that they don't act like one, all right? Women can act the same way in a relationship as in a man and female relationship. A female and female can act the same way in a relationship. So don't think for once that bitches don't act like that when they're in a relationship with another female. Look how she's treating you. She's acting like she's the man and she's the shit. All right? Now, here's the thing. What should you do? You want to leave her standing? Bitch, please, Olivia, leave that bitch standing. Let her be with her best friend. They could be broke together, living with each other's guardians, and snap it up on Facebook, social media. Why would you want to be irritated? Your first relationship with a female should not be one like this, which is hazardous and unhealthy, okay? That's your first experience with a woman. Don't let it be the worst experience to where it just turns you totally off from women and you don't even want to bother with women in general. You need to have a good, healthy relationship, especially with the opposite sex for the first time. If you were into women all this time, then it would be a different story. But this is your first relationship, and why not make it a really, really good experience? She is a sour note, okay? A sour fucking note. And me, honestly, I would ditch that bitch in a heartbeat. I'd leave that bitch in a ditch, okay? Ooh, that's a new one. Leave that bitch in a ditch, okay? And you can use that for men, too, because they act like bitches, too. So leave that bitch in a ditch, all right? For real, leave her the fuck alone. Life is too short. Handle her and keep it moving. Let her be with her best friend. I'm just saying. Mm-hmm. So here is the last one. And this is a short one. I have nothing but short ones today, and I'm really happy about that. Hi, April. I love your channel and your style. Oh, thank you. I have been watching your videos for a long time. Let's get started so you can call me Bree and my friend Kia. So anyway, me and Kia have been friends since we were 9 years old, and I am 27 now, and Kia is 28. Me and Kia have always been real close. We even lived together when we were in college. I consider Kia a sister and have always been there for her, and her likewise. So about 2 years ago, she asked me if she could get her electricity turned on in my name because she didn't have any other option, and I really needed help. I told her I don't know if that was a good idea, but she assured me that it would be fine and she wouldn't let the bill go bad. So I said, okay, big fucking mistake. A few days ago, I checked my credit report and learned that Kia has racked up almost $4,000 worth of debt in my damn name now. Now I have to go and prove it's fraud against me. So, again, fraud against my so-called friend Kia. I don't have a clue that I know what she did, April. I'm so mad and hurt. I feel so stupid for even helping her. Should I confront her or let the police handle it? Like, surprise, bitch, you busted and this friendship is over. She is my only non-relative best friend. Please help. Sorry, this is kind of long. Thanks, April. Well, it wasn't long at all. So it's Kia and Bree. So Kia and Bree have been friends since they have been 9 years old. And Kia had needed some help. She needed to get her electricity turned on. So she asked Bree if she would let her use her name, basically her social security number. And Bree agreed to it after Kia stated that she would make sure the bills were paid, she wouldn't let it go sour, etc., etc. And so she agreed. Well, Bree took a look at her credit report and seen that Kia done racked up $4,000 worth of damages to Bree's credit. And so now, in order for Bree to get this taken off of her credit report, she is going to have to go and claim as a fraud, basically kind of like identity theft. And she doesn't know whether she should tell she doesn't know whether she should tell Kia or let the cops show up. All right. First of all, it really wasn't fraud. It might have been fraud, depending on what else did she use the social number for. Did you just like give her your social number and tell her to just go ahead and turn it on? Does she have your social number? Or is it $4,000 in the electricity bill? I would think if you racked up $4,000 in bad credit in debt for electricity bill, that they would have been shut your fucking lights off. Okay, that's just what I'm thinking, but I could be incorrect about that. Now, I just had a brain freeze. Now, as far as you calling the police or letting the police show up at her door, I don't really think that's right, okay? Because for one, you agreed to allow her to use your information, okay? Now, it's partially both of you guys' faults, all right? Because if you had never gave her your social number and your date of birth and all of that good stuff, then none of this would have been taking place. She would have never had any of this information if you did not give it to her. Now, I'm not saying what she did was wrong, and I'm not saying what she did was right, but you guys both played a part in it. So what I think the best thing to do is for you and her both to figure this out, to get this payment, this debt taken care of without involving the police. Because at the end of the day, Bree, you allowed her. You played a part in this. And I'm not saying that it's wrong, but it's not right what she did to you. It's definitely not right. However, it's not right for you to allow the police to pick her up on something that you agreed to. So that's making you look like a bad friend as well. It's a standard. Now, should you tell her? Yes, you should confront her. Why wouldn't you? I personally would not have liked a surprise knock on my door from the police, and then she's hauled down to the police station and all of this shit. That's not cool. That's not going to make you feel good as a friend. That's not going to sit well with you. That's not going to sit well with her. You know what I mean? You guys both played a part in this whole electricity scheme, and on both of you guys' part, it's a fraud, honestly. Whether you know it or not, there are people that use their children's social security numbers to get their lights on or their lights turned off. Yes, we all may have done it, and it doesn't make it right. Even if it is your children, that's still considered fraud. And even though you allowed her and you gave her your name and social to use to turn her lights on, you still committed a fraud because you were not there. You were not living there. You gave her your information knowingly and willingly that it would turn her lights on, okay? So you guys both committed a fraud, okay? So it's not right for you to say to any kind of law enforcement that you did not know about what she did because you did know about it. Now, if she took your social number and ran with it and opened up some other type of accounts besides the electricity account, then girl, baby, bye. Bye, Felicia. I'm going to let you go down for that because, first of all, that was not right for you to go ahead and use my info on some other shit. Now, that ain't right. But before you get taken down by the police, I'm going to have to confront you and I might have to go upside your head with some shit too. However, if the debt is all nothing but the electric bill, then you guys both played a part in this. And I think that you guys both need to deal with this together as women. You both are grown women. As women, you guys both need to deal with this together. And that's just my opinion on it. Don't take your friend down because you're in debt and you don't want to pay some bill off. You played a part in this and you already knew from the jump that it wasn't a good idea. So therefore, you knew what you were stepping into. You knew you were stepping into the flame. You knew that fire was going to burn your ass alive. And it did. It bit you in the butt. But now what you need to do is you need to confront her and handle it like two women. And let her know, listen, if you don't pay this off, then I'm going to have to seek legal action. People don't like to be threatened with legal action. I'm guaranteeing you she's probably going to be like, okay, girl, let's work on this together. Offer some type of solution to the problem. Because going to jail, putting her in jail, is not the solution to the problem. Especially if you guys both agreed on it and both willingly did this together. Then, you know what? You both played a part in this and you both need to deal with it together. And that's my take on it. So, let Bree know what you guys think about the situation. I don't think it's right. No, I don't. But you know what? I would have never gave nobody my social security number to open up no type of account. I don't give a fuck who you are, alright? You ain't about to fuck up my credit. It's already fucked up shit, but I ain't about to let you fucking dig it and put that bitch in a ditch. Fuck that. So on that note, leave your comments below, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this real talk. Stay diva and divalicious. And I'll see you guys on my next video. Make sure you check out my collaboration video tomorrow, which Yes Loves Me. And use that coupon code MUFFIN20 at time of checkout.